Hello, welcome to CACE International. I'm Fikisha Kumbo. On this edition, we have some very special guests in the studio, Hassan Hakmoun and Said Hakmoun from Marrakesh, Morocco. They live in the United States now, and they head a group called Zahar. But first, we're going to look at some slides from Marrakesh. These are slides of the Berber tribe, the Gnawa, and the Fantasia horsemen. And the music we're going to hear behind this is the music of Zahar, led by Hassan Hakmoun. We'll be back in just a second. Enjoy. Hassan, welcome, you and Said, to CACE International. Your music is just fantastic. When I first heard it on David Sanborn, it just riveted me. I had to stop and listen. What are the elements? I hear so much stuff going on in your music.
Yeah, well, it's like this music has a lot of different rhythmic. Like when you hear the music, the Gnawa music, you can find there's Brazilian music in it, or jazz, blues, all kind of music, rhythmic, it's in this music.
You know, I also hear something of the call response. You know, in early American slavery, we black people came mm-hmm. from Africa, as you know, the song of the call response was the kind of music that was very happening in that time. In fact, it still goes on.
Yeah, so we have the same kind in this music too, yeah. As like singing and answering, you know, because, yeah, this music, it's come from the slave. You know, they bring it from West Africa and to Morocco as coming as slave to work for the king of Morocco 500 years ago. Uh-huh. And they've been playing, after like they finished their job, they've been playing this music in the palace, just the family. Uh-huh. And then people been listening to the music and the music become popular. And it's like they play and the people got trance and they dance, but after that, they cannot remember what they've been doing.
Uh-huh.
It's not like just stand up and dance.
Yeah.
It comes with the feeling.
So the Gnawan people came to Morocco from West Africa, say Timbuktu and places like
that.
Yeah,
Gambia, Senegal, all, you know,
uh-huh.
Guinea, you know, all
like 500 years ago.
Yeah.
As slaves.
Yeah.
To work for the king.
Yeah.
And this music. I understand the Ghanaians, the Gnawans, I rather.
Yeah.
Originated a certain kind of instrument, some kind of drum?
Yeah, they have a big drum, like, you know, like a bass drums in the drum, something
uh-huh.
like that, but made as traditional and with like goat skin, you know.
Uh-huh.
And they have other instruments as like this cas. Can you
see
that side?
Let me see that side.
Yeah, this is, they play this too as like a cas.
Okay.
They're called Karkaba.
Call what?
Karkaba.
Karkaba.
Yeah.
Okay. And what about this particular, they're going to play for us in just a minute though, but.
Yeah, this instrument, it has like three string, it's two and half,
uh-huh.
and made from goat.
Okay.
Goat
skin?
No, goat.
Okay.
Goat.
Gat goat. That's the name of a goat?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And this is the goat skin here?
Yeah, this is the goat.
What is this
No,
called?
This is a camel skin.
Oh, this is camel skin?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, this instrument has like seven name. See, in Africa they have different name, but in my country we have seven name. Mm. They call it Sentier, Hajhuj, Gugu, Gnibri, that dude. You know.
Okay, well, get me straight here. Now, what on this is goat? If this is camel.
Yeah, this is a camel. This is a stomach, the goat. You know.
This is the goat.
Yeah.
Goat gut.
Goat gut. That's
okay,
what I'm saying.
Okay, I got
say.
You. I got you.
Goat gut. Sometimes I get confused. Yeah,
that's sometimes. Okay. How and why did you come to America?
I come to America to play in Lincoln Center. We're having a show with some group called Nomadas Dance.
Okay.
They're from, some of them from Spain, some of them from the state, and the musicians are from Morocco. So we got a group together and we come here to play.
Uh-huh.
Then I was like playing the music and I did stay.
So how long have you been here now?
It's almost like 4.5 years.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So you're old hat now.
Yeah.
You know what that expression is, old hat? You've been here a long time.
Yeah.
What is the story? There's a story behind how you got involved
with
Gnawa music. Yes, please tell us that.
The story is my mom, she would bring, she used to trance dance to do this music, and she invited the musician come over to our house and play like all night, you know, from like 9 o'clock nighttime to 1 o'clock in the morning.
Mm.
And then I was 6 years old that time, and I was always come to, after they finish drumming, I come to the drumming and keep playing with it to when I fall to sleep and they take me, and I cannot let go of the drum. I was holding the drum with me while I was sleeping. Then one time my sister got a problem in her body, like, and then they bring this musician to play for her, and they did.
The Gnawa
music. Yeah. And then she felt all right, so I fell in love with the music. So I become playing music when I was started again when I was 7 years old, and keep going every party with the musician and listening. So, and I was 10, I left my family and I was working for myself.
How old were you then?
10.
Uh-huh.
10, I left the city where I'm from and go every city in Morocco.
You went as a 10-year-old?
Yeah.
With musicians though, with older musicians?
No, at first I started with my brother. He's younger than me.
He's younger.
Yeah, and people, they think, said you have to go to school, you don't have, you know, go learn something in school. And I said, no, I want to learn this music. You know, and I've been playing people, like, sometimes we go to rent a room in a hotel and they don't accept us because it's too young and we cannot have IDs and stuff.
Yeah. So you went around to meet master musicians?
Yeah. Master musician and play for people and make money.
What does it mean to be a master musician?
To be a master, you have to work with a master as playing this
instrument. We're talking about a master Gnawan musician.
Yeah, that's why. To be a master, you have to play with the master musician who play this instrument. You play this in you know, near him. For him, you know, you play the cascade for him and he play the sentier.
Okay.
And then you watch him playing. Because this music doesn't write, you cannot write it down and read it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, now you can, but like when I was learning, no any master can write this music, you know, for the other student to learn.
Wow.
You learn by watching where his finger going, and by hearing the music and the sound, and you keep, after that you go home and practice.
So how much do you have to learn in order to be a master musician? And what qualifies?
When I was, like, I started with 7 and 10, I left the family. In 14, I will become master.
So you had to know how much?
I have to know, like, 200 songs.
200 songs?
Yeah. Some, you know, and I have to learn how I can play all night, like the whole night ceremony for the people who dance, trance dancing.
Oh, yeah.
I have to learn how I can dance and sing and, yeah.
Now, you have the group called Zahar.
Yeah, Zahar.
That's the group I saw on David Sanborn, right?
Well, it's like they changed a little bit. I have a different guitar player.
Oh, okay.
His name Anthony, produced in Michael, you know.
Yeah.
And I have the drummers, Bill McLennan, and Ital Shore and Kibo, and Chido and Conga.
Yeah, and of course Saeed here.
Saeed is dancing, singing, you know, percussion.
So would you do
he play also the music?
You play the same,
yeah.
Well, since we have these instruments here, do you think you could play a little bit for us?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Oh, fantastic. So we have Said Hakmoun on the castanets, and Hassan Hakmoun playing the sintir. This is a treat, you know. I love it. That's wonderful. I can feel the trance-like feeling coming from that music.
Right.
What? I want you to tell me about the dance, the Gnawa dance, and after that, what are the lyrics talking about? After you tell me about the Gnawa dance, tell me about the lyrics of the music.
The lyrics of the music, it's... See, when they start like the ceremony in the nighttime, they sing about God and Prophet and like spiritual, and they sing about the people who's been playing this music before, the master and the people who's brought this music a long time ago. They keep in saying their name, and they have. Some song like her, like keeping singing the song, and the people watching, you know, the audience sitting down. And when we playing this music, there is no smoking, no alcohol, no anything except innocent, you know.
Yeah.
So when they start singing and playing, you, in 1 second, you see people jumping everywhere and falling down in the front of the master and the Gnawa musician. Then you start playing for that person to when he finished dancing, and, you know, trance dance. It's not like normal dance. He's dancing, but he doesn't know what to do. So you've been playing for him to when he stops. You don't have to stop to when he stops.
Uh-huh.
And then he stops and change to the other song. If he doesn't stop, he keep going.